The brand new Samsung Galaxy Fold is here. Samsung has just launched the Galaxy Fold in Korea and it's coming soon to other markets. Hello guys, my name is Vic with PhoneArena and I got to spend some time with the brand new September edition of the Galaxy Fold here at IFA 2019 in Berlin, and these are my first impressions with the device. The most important thing about the new Galaxy Fold is that it's basically the same as the old one, plus three major fixes that help it endure the tests of time. And first of all, Samsung has protected the device from debris entering inside the phone and breaking it, something that was an issue back in April when it first launched the device to the media and to select testers. And the first thing that it did is at the top and the bottom parts, right where the hinge is, you can see there are tiny plastic caps that protect the device and don't allow debris to enter. The second thing is that what used to look like a screen protector and actually was an integral part of the screen is now hidden. It's tucked under the side of the phone, so you don't actually see it, you don't get to chop it off, so it's well protected. And previously this used to be an issue. And thirdly, you also have an even tinier gap between the hinge and the back and front covers of the phone, so debris cannot enter from there. There are other minor improvements to the design of the Galaxy Fold. For example, when you just press the main screen, you used to have a bit of a travel, a bit of a wobble on the first device, and now Samsung has included layers of metal to make it feel much more solid and comfortable to use. And in terms of the rest of the specs, there are no changes. Under the hood, the Galaxy Fold still features the Snapdragon 855 system chip. It still comes with a massive 12 gigabytes of RAM. You still get 512 gigabytes of onboard storage, which is a ton. So basically no changes. The camera setup is the same. This is the same device we saw in April, but relaunched for September 2019. And that is a bit of a disappointment. Samsung had a couple of months and it could have introduced a few new software features to make use of that giant 7.3 inch screen. And this really, guys, this feels like the future. The screen is truly massive. We tried playing games on it. We tried multitasking on it. And it is a joy. It is a huge screen, especially for gaming, for reading. It's much more comfortable. You can have, for example, three apps open at the same time in a split screen view, and then you can have a floating fourth app on top of it. This really makes a big difference for multitasking, makes it much more comfortable than on your traditional smartphone display. Speaking of multitasking, you have app continuity on the Galaxy Fold, and what this means is that, for example, you can open a Google Maps on the tiny 4.6 inch screen on the front, the so-called cover display, and then you open the device and boom, you're right there on the same spot in the map, just on a much larger screen. You have a much better view. You can do the same thing for messaging. You can start typing on the small screen, then open the big screen, and you're back there at the same messaging app. Or for example, you can even do this with gaming, but probably the better example is cameras. You can open the camera on the smaller screen and then switch to the large screen and get that much bigger view. The other small thing that Samsung has changed to the software is the navigation buttons. You used to have those right at the bottom center, and now by default they are positioned on the right hand side, which is much more convenient for single-handed use. It's much easier to reach for all three buttons. If you are left-handed, you can have them move to the left-hand side, again, very convenient, and you can also bring them back to the center if that is something that you prefer. You have this option in the settings. We should also mention that the crease right in the middle of the phone is there. It is noticeable, and when you run your finger through the middle of the screen, you can definitely see and feel that it's there. But honestly, I don't think that's a deal breaker in any significant way. It's not even as noticeable as the notch which is on the side of the phone. You can see the crease under certain angles, but it's not a deal breaker. The other thing that has not changed from the original Galaxy Fold design is that you have a separate power button and a separate button for the fingerprint scanner, which are right next to each other. That's a bit of a weird decision, but it's still there. The fingerprint scanner is on the side and the power button is right above it. What seems to have not changed are the prices. Now, the prices for the Samsung Galaxy Fold still start at around the $2,000 mark, which is really expensive. The device is launching on September 6th in Samsung's home market of Korea, and then it's coming on September 18th to the UK, Germany, France, and a few other countries. And there is a launch planned for the US later on, but Samsung is not providing a specific date just yet. So that's it, guys. A quick peek at the future phone, the first true foldable phone out on the market in a meaningful way. It's here, it works, it's really exciting to try it. It's something new in a sea of look-alike devices. This is something different, this is something exciting. We personally are not sure that you should go out and spend $2,000 on a first-gen product, but if you get the chance to try it out, it's definitely worth it and you definitely will like it. So that's it, guys, a quick preview of the Samsung Galaxy Fold. Thumbs up if you enjoyed watching this video, subscribe to see even more. You can find us on the web at www.phonearena.com. My name is Vic, signing off, and I'll talk to you in the next one.